In this video, we are going to talk about Zoho Mail, the security section. If you care about security, probably you need to see it and you need to take action. So first of all, you will need to go to the My Profile. You need to be the system administrator or at least the administrator of the service Zoho Mail. You can click on the admin console and then you will see your system. The first thing that you need to do is if you have a domain, the domain need to have some kind of configuration. The SPF and DKIM will be a must. DMARC will be nice to have. MX means that the server that is running the emails will be Zoho. The SPF, it will be against spoofing. The DKIM means that you are you. So I'm sending email on behalf of amazingbusinessresults.com. That means that I own it. So the DKIM, it's a way for you to say that you are really you and not someone pretending to be you. The DMARC will be what to do with emails that are not being delivered, and you can have your different levels of how to deal with it. And the last one will be the BIMI. The BIMI will be very cool. It will be a small logo beside the emails that you're sending. So people will see that it was sent from Amazing Business Results. It's very nice. You can have also the security and compliance sections. Right now, my security and compliance are 57. Not good enough. I like to see it around the 90s. Here you can see different suggestions of what needs to be done. So for example, you can have here the cousin domain verification, which I will talk to you about it in a second as well. Domain name verification. You have a bunch of things that needs to be done. And as you go through them, you will have more and more points and it will really protect you. So that's important. The security section, it's only for people that are on Zoho Mail. If you're on Zoho One, you don't need to take care of that because it's being taken care of from the Zoho One section. If you are on Zoho Mail or Workspace, you will need to. You can have your settings about the login. People logging in to the system. How long will be the passwords, if you can use passwords from the history and so on. Suspicious logins, if it's turned on, you can see people that are trying to log in with your email and they're failing, you can see them here. SMIME, if you turn it on, I can't do it because I don't have a certificate, it will be a special certificate that is being produced, and this certificate will communicate emails between you and the other parties that having also a certificate, it will communicate in high security level. So the basic will be TLS, which is encryption that already exists on all the emails that Zoho are sending, but that will be a security on steroids. So that's also possible. The spam control, you can have multiple settings. One of them will be the allowed list. You can have people that are always on this list and they will always be approved. You can do it per email or per domain. If you want, you can also have IP addresses that will be allowed. So that will be servers and so on. You can also define blacklist. The blacklist can be people that you want to block, domains that you want to block, IP addresses that you want to block, and so on. You can also define patterns. Let's define a pattern, and that will be some regular expression and so on. So if someone is sending you a JavaScript or send you anything like that, you can define it here. So you can define patterns that are harmful for your system, or you know that those will be some patterns that you don't want to have. The spam verification, I always like to put everything in quarantine. So whenever emails are being sent and those emails are nasty, they will go to the quarantine section. So if, for example, people send you emails and they don't have the SPF on, what I showed you before in the domain, instead of just rejecting them or do nothing, I want to move them to the quarantine. Now in 2025, there is no reason in the world why a company, a legit company, will not have SPF defined or DKIM defined. No reason in the world. So in that case, they will move to quarantine. I have an email that's being sent to me on a daily basis that tells me, hey, check the quarantine. So I'm checking once a day. Sometimes I see good stuff. Most of the time it's all shit. So I don't need them anyway. So I will move all of them to move to quarantine across the board. That's me personally. You can do something else. We have also international. Oh, this is cool. You can block if you want certain countries and certain languages. So let's say that you're getting tons of spam from, again, I don't want to sound racist and, you know, people will send me comments about me hating people, but some language or some country, they're spamming me all the time. I can choose that ear, okay? And then I can block them. And also some countries, so I can do that, okay? So I can control it as well. The phishing and malware, for people that don't know, sometimes people, and it's happening a lot. Lots of our customers got hit by scammers over the years, and millions of dollars went to shit. You have domain. So my domain will be amazingbusinessresults.com. Whenever emails coming in, my brain sees it and says, yeah, it's fine. But what if it will be amazing, but instead of I, it will be one? Or instead of this I, it will be just L. It's really difficult to see that. Or maybe instead of 2S, I will have 3S. So most people will just cruise around it, looks fine, continue. In this section, I am able to add domains that are similar to mine, but they're not mine. So what I did, or what I like to do, I go to ChatGPT and I say, create a list of cousin domains that I want to block. And my email is amazingbusiness.com. I will click enter. It will give me 50 domains that more likely to be the ones that I will get hit by. And I will add them here. The moment that you do that, whenever those domains will come here, they will move to quarantine. So you will be able to see them. Maybe once in a blue moon, you will have one that makes sense, but sometimes not. Also for malware, I don't like JavaScript in emails. I also don't like objects in emails. And sometimes I don't like also frames. So people can inject stuff. Macros also, not great. So those will be the bare minimum. You can have more if you want. The more you have, the more emails will go to the spam area and someone will need to check them. It's important. The quarantine sections will show the quarantine email of the company, my quarantine, what was delivered, what was denied, if there were any exports. All that is very important to check. This is why you have an admin panel. Some companies, they never ever go to those areas and they are missing business. So it's important. The more security you have in your company, the more people need to check what's going on, because you have lots of false positives. It's part of security. It will always be there. So it's important. That's it, really. Those are the big things that you can see in terms of security. You have more things. This is more recovery and stuff like that, but it's not really security. I will give you one more thing. There is a website named XMX Toolbox. This is a website that allows you to check problems with your domain. So let's say that my email is amazingbusinessresults.com. I will go to MX Toolbox. It will tell me who is my email provider. It will say, for example, the quarantine reject policy is not enabled, but the DMARC for that is enabled. This is the analyze header, this one. So you can push you the headers of an email, let's say that is being rejected by one of your clients, and it will tell you exactly why it was rejected. So you will know the problem and then you can fix it. So they have a bunch of nice tools here. Most of them are free. If you want to pay them, obviously you can. So that's also something that can help you on the security side and also troubleshoot problems that most of the times other companies can't solve. So that's also something useful. That's it. Enough talking. Thank you very much for watching this session. Questions, everything in the comments below. More clicks, links about our company, description. Thank you. Bye.